as we explore quantum body and beyond, one of the questions that comes up very frequently is, why is mathematics so effective in describing natural laws? And you know, the whole quantum revolution was brought about by theoretical physicists who were also mathematicians. In fact, you can't do theoretical physics without knowing math, and quantum mechanics, Schrodinger's equation, E equal to mc squared, relativity, general relativity, all these phenomena in nature, including natural laws, are first glimpsed mathematically. So why is mathematics so unreasonably effective? In 1960, Eugene Wigner, a great scientist, wrote a paper actually called The Unreasonable Effectiveness of Mathematics in Natural Sciences. And he highlighted several examples of this effectiveness. Number one, precise predictions. Mathematical models derived from fundamental physical principles can predict natural phenomena with incredible accuracy, often exceeding our ability to measure them. There are unforeseen applications. Abstractions developed for purely theoretical purposes often find unexpected applications in various branches of physics, sometimes decades or even centuries earlier. And then there's discovery. The mathematical structure of existing theories often points the way towards new discoveries and deeper understanding of the laws of nature. Wigner never offered a solution to this unreasonable effectiveness of mathematics. So I'm going to try and give you one, okay? And I am going to suggest that both math and the physical world and the natural laws of the physical world are actually qualia experiences in consciousness. That what we call math describes the regularities and the symmetries of nature, and what we call natural laws are similarly regularities of experiences in consciousness, and they appear as qualia in our awareness. They match, the qualia match the qualia, because both what we call the laws of nature and math are expressions of regularities of experience in non-local awareness. So there has been suggestion that qualia, subjective experiences and qualities of conscious perception, might actually bridge the gap between mathematics and the physical world. For example, the intuition and understanding we develop through qualia means qualities of awareness, spatial awareness, visual patterns, color, etc., might guide us towards choosing the right mathematical tools to describe qualia. Ultimately, I think everything that we call reality is a quality of awareness. What we call the alchemy of sensations is nothing other than qualia. Even as I pose this question to you, the question itself is a qualia, because it appears as sensations, an alchemy of sensations, which are qualities of experience. So if we consider qualia as subjective, non-reducible aspects of experience, then my question, any answer you get, and any experience you get out of that will be shaped by qualia. Qualia, of course, are shaped by our individual experiences, and qualia are also appearing on the screen of consciousness. Any sensation, however subtle, a thought, a feeling, an emotion, a regularity, a mathematical construct, and the appearance of the physical world are qualia. And so even quantum mechanics is qualia. Qualia is the answer. Qualities of experience in consciousness create both the appearance of the physical world and the mathematics to describe it and even predict the future evolution of the universe. Let me know what you think.